Harriet Beecher Stowe that wrote Uncle Tom's Cabin was in our family tree, that we were related to Harriet Beecher Stowe, but they couldn't tell us how, okay? So about 2 years ago, I had my DNA done through Ancestry, and I got on Ancestry.com and just started building our family tree. And one of my goals was to figure out how we were related to Harriet Beecher Stowe. And I found out. Are any of y'all on Ancestry? It is amazing. I'm telling you, you all want to get your DNA done and do it. It's so much fun. It's like putting a puzzle together.
Karen will do that for you.
I'll do it for you. It's a lot of fun. But anyway, so what I learned is that, and how the Beecher is in our line is, do y'all remember, most of you are too young, but our great-grandmother was a Beecher, Jessie Beecher Coker. Okay, so she was our grandmother Bill's mother. Okay, our great-grandmother, Manson and Kenia's grandmother. She was born in Missouri right after the Civil War in 1875. And her father, Sanford Beecher, was a doctor. He was a physician and he practiced in the Civil War, and we're just assuming that he kind of moved around during the Civil War to practice medicine. The mother, do you have that picture that we've always hung on the kitchen wall of Grandmother Cooper's mother with her hair up? Okay, but that's okay. We have a picture of her. But anyway, shortly after Grandmother Beecher, we call Jessie Coker, that was her married name, shortly after she was born in 1875, her mother died, okay? And the father, Dr. Beecher, we think was not there. I don't know if he was off practicing medicine. It was right after the Civil War. So there was, the family lore is that there was kind of a scuffle between one of Jessie's older sisters and another family friend, literally pulling on the baby to see who would take the baby and raise her, because our grandmother was very, very young. She was just a newborn. And this non-relative won and got her, okay, and left Missouri and took her to Iron City, Tennessee, where she was raised. The last name of this woman was Vaughn. And I don't know if she was married or single at the time, but she later married. She raised grandmother as a Vaughn. She was kidnapped. And grandmother never knew that she was really a Beecher until this woman was on her deathbed and confessed and told grandmother that she had taken her and that she was really a Beecher. She told her what she knew about her family. And after that woman died, grandmother went back to Missouri to find her family. On Ancestry, I have been able to find our grandmother's marriage certificate, and it even has her last name as Vaughn. So she was raised as a Vaughn, not a Beecher. But anyway, so in doing the family history, of so just
when you're saying grandmother, you mean our great-grandmother?
Our great-grandmother, who we do is great-grandmother Coker.
Okay. Our mother's Coker, my mother's.
Yeah, it's her.
That's what I thought. I just wanted to make sure.
It's our grandmother Bill's mother.
Okay, that's what I thought.
Our grandmother Bill's mother. So our great grandmother, their grandmother. So when I started tracking the feature line on Ancestry, it was really easy to track. It was just click, 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 and it would take you back generation upon generation. And so what I found was that they go all the way back as far as when they immigrated to America. They came from Kent, England, and they came on a ship in 1658, I think. Let me get my notes up here. 1637. Further back than I thought. 1637. And the first Beecher immigrant that came was named Isaac Beecher. So he is like it'd be Mark, our like eighth grade grandfather, just straight up direct ancestors. And Isaac Beecher, they came, they were they were Puritans in England, okay? So they came over here and the ship was coming to Boston. They landed in Boston, but the Quakers were already into a religious fight in Boston, and they didn't want to get in the middle of that, so they got on a ship and just went up the harbor and came to what is now New Haven, Connecticut, but there was nothing there except an Indian village. So that's where they settled, and so they built the town of New Haven. And they were there hundreds of years, very prominent, owned lots of land. And so our family took a trip to New York in March, and New Haven is not far from New York. So the last couple of days of the trip, we went to New Haven because I was able to find a lot of things online that we wanted to see. Shortly after, I mean, which is just a few weeks of the ship landing in New Haven, they had an outdoor church worship service. And they founded this church that is still there today. Obviously, it's not the same building. But it's, we brought a bunch of pictures for anybody who wants to look at them. The church is still in existence as far as the congregation goes. And they still have services there. We went to a church service there. And they have all kinds of inscriptions about these early settlers that started this church. It has the date of the first worship service, which would have been like the spring of 1638. And then in New Haven, that's where Yale University is. In New Haven, there's a There's a big open space area. I think it's 17 acres. Think of the quad at the University of Alabama, just a big open green space. That's called the Green. That was the town square when they first settled the town. And they buried everybody there. Okay, this is the green space, and that's the church. And so everybody for decades was buried in this area called the Green. They estimate that there are 5,000 to 10,000 people buried there. And the markers are removed, but the remains are still there. So we were walking on Isaac, our eighth grandfather. But there were still tombstones there, dating back to the 1700s, including Isaac's son, our seventh great-grandfather. So they have moved those tombstones, and we have pictures of them, to another cemetery that they had started across the street. And so we've got pictures, you won't be able to see them up close, but Manson's got them on the PowerPoint. And so Isaac's son, John, is our direct descendant. And we've got a picture of his tombstone. He died in 1712. And then Isaac had a son named Ebenezer. And so he would be our sixth great-grandfather. We went to a different cemetery and saw his. We got a picture of his tombstone. And Ebenezer had a son named Thomas. We've got a picture of his tombstone and their wives. And there are Beechers buried everywhere up there. We got Beecher gravestones. We don't even know who they are. But
more
anyway,
more
Beechers than there are Beals. And so it turns out that I did find Harriet Beecher Stowe, and she is in our family tree, but she is not in our direct line. So go back to Isaac, the first immigrant that landed in 1637. Isaac had five sons. We come from the oldest son, John. That's the one that we got the tombstone picture of. That's our direct ascendant, ancestor. Harriet came from one of the other sons, okay? And I actually tracked her, you know, her lineage all the way down. So I think genealogically, Harriet is, mind your mark, she's like our fourth cousin five times removed.
We share the same.
Let me look.
According to what you sent me,
yeah.
Lyman Beecher,
yes.
The Lyman,
yes.
Was her father,
yes.
The father of Harriet Beecher.
Yes. Harriet Beecher's father was Lyman.
He's buried.
They are still up there in New Haven. He was born and died in New Haven, and we've got a picture of his tomb, because he's buried near our John, and he's in a big tomb. And he's buried right by Noah Webster of Webster's Dictionary. Eli Whitney, we got pictures of him. Eli Whitney of the Cotton Gin. And Morse. Jedediah Morse, as in the Morse code. I'm sure they were named Morse. Yeah.
And we share the same seven grandfathers.
Yeah, yeah. And he's buried in Noah Webster. Isaac the immigrant is mine and yours, eighth great grandfather. Okay, we walked on him, but we didn't see it. We walked on him, but we didn't see his grave. So his son John, that died in 1712, we got a picture of that grave, and he's our seventh great grandfather. His son Ebenezer Beecher is our sixth, and we got a picture of that. His son Thomas is our fifth. We've got a picture of his gravestone. And Thomas had a son, Thomas, okay? And that Thomas was born in 1746, and he was born in Connecticut. But then he moved to St. Louis, Missouri. And that's where the line continued, where the physician, Dr. Beecher, that's our second great-grandfather, married Jesse, who was kidnapped. So that's our family story for today. Amazing. But you're welcome to come look at these pictures. And like I say, Manson's got them. I don't know if you're going to see them on PowerPoint. It's just